Hey guys, and welcome to another video. And in this video, I've got a question to ask for you guys. But before I ask, please don't forget to like, don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to do all that good stuff for me and help me grow the channel. But the question that I have for you is, I want you to watch this video in its entirety. Because there's some analysis at the end and there's something that happens during the race, which I have a question for you. So, there's an incident during this race that I crash into the back of someone, okay? And I want you to pause the video at that point and I want you to comment in the description below and I want to know if you think that I'm at fault or the other driver's at fault. So just put your fault or other driver's fault, okay? And then I want you to watch the analysis at the end. And I then want you to put either you changed your mind or don't, I haven't changed my mind, okay? I'm not going to give it away, guys. Watch the video and you'll see my analysis around why I believe that this wasn't my fault and how there's a bit of ambiguity around the driver behind is always at fault. You'll understand this when you watch the video in its entirety. And I'll leave it at that, guys. So until the next video, take care, and I'll catch you in the next.
That's 20 minutes to go. 20 minutes.
I definitely feel we could go faster.
Fastest lap for Danny, 1:43.32. Danny is leading the race. Sixth place.
Yeah, we're losing a ton of time here. Come on, mate, you've got a clear track in front. Come on.
Claudio, don't let this guy distract you.
Yeah, this Lambo's gonna cause us problems. That's got to be a track warning for this guy.
That last lap was at 1:45.00.
Thank you.
radio. Keep Prattle under pressure. He'll make a mistake.
Oh my God. Serious.
Hold your line. Clear right. Right side. Hold your line. Clear right. Car right. Still there.
I'm actually not even sure what happened there. Like,
hold your line. Clear right.
Like, I broke really early.
Car in front is NRTH.
We'll watch the replay, but it felt like he literally just stopped on the corner.
So, guys, we're going to analyse this incident that took place into the hairpin at Barcelona. You've watched the video. You should have come up with your own opinions about whose fault this was. And on face value, you should be saying that it was my fault. I even messaged the guy to say that I was sorry, but I'm an analytical person and I like to understand why things happened. So we're going to take this to the lap before the crash, okay? So on lap four, we're going to analyse this guy's braking point, okay? And I've slowed it right down so that you will be able to see the brake lights coming on. And so we're approaching the 150. We're past the 150. And the brake lights come on. Okay. So that was the lap before, okay, the crash. Now, I've logged that. And I'm kind of like, okay, I understand where you're braking. I understand where I'm braking. And when, if we carry this on, actually, where I was braking, I thought to myself, I'm getting quite close. Because let's go into the, I'm getting quite close to him. And I felt a little bit uncomfortable. Okay, that there was no room for error there. Okay, so let's take it one lap further. So we're taking it one lap further. Let's go into his car. Slow it right down. Remember, he broke past the 150 last time. And on this occasion, he's braking at the 150. Now, I broke early in comparison to what we did the previous lap. But because he's braked even earlier than that, then there's nothing. It felt to me like he just stopped. So we'll take it at full speed. So because he broke so early, there was nothing I could do. It felt like he was stopping in the middle of the corner. Now I'm going to take it to a completely different lap. Lap 8. And we're going to go on board with our guy. And we're going to slow it right down again. Remember, he broke at the 150 on the lap that we crashed. And again, he's braking well past the 150. Okay. So, on the face of it, you can see how that might be my fault. And if this guy clips the video and sends it to LFM, LFM aren't going to look at all of what I've just shown you. All they're going to show is the driver behind must take more care in not crashing into the car in front. And actually, there's a little bit of an argument on whether the car in front is acting inconsistently. I'd like to hear your thoughts. Obviously, you had your opinions before because I've asked you to. And what are your thoughts now? Are you still thinking it's my fault, or do you think that it's inconsistent braking and actually there's something, there's more to it? I'd love to hear your comments in the comments below. Until the next video, guys, please like if you liked the video. Comment, I'd like to hear your comments, and subscribe. I will catch you in the next video, guys. Take care.